it's always exciting when you can start to monitor the sharks themselves. So we were able to start layering in shark tagging. One of our goals was to really just see, is it possible to tag sharks here? What's that look like? How do we do it safely? And can we start putting some identification tags in these animals? The first couple days were a little rocky, not gonna lie, because there's some new people in the mix. It's a relatively younger team. So I had to be pretty hands-on, as you have to be sometimes on expeditions, which is okay. After the first couple days, everybody was just in the flow state and clicking. It was great. So you have everybody jumping in to help, whether they're taking photos, shooting video, or even holding a shark when it's on the back of the boat.
Bringing the shark in can really be like challenging for the shark, but once they're flat at the, just below the surface like that, they're actually very calm. We take a blood sample, we take a muscle sample, we take a tissue sample, and we put a tag in, and there's no movement from that.
We got a big shark, we got a big nurse.
Fork length, 172.
Okay. My name is Alyssa Dorfman, and I am a research assistant with Beneath the Waves. For the tagging data that I took the measurement so we could see the size of the sharks. I took the data for the tags that we had, so the numbers, so if someone sees them, we could look back and say, hey, this is a Caribbean reef shark.
Data collection's going great. We're getting awesome blood samples, thanks to Jamie, and input by Natalie, and hopefully this nurse is looking bigger than the last.
Or if we get a shark, I want you to tag it. All right. Let's tag it.
What happened, Jay?
Oh, I just took blood on the first time, but I tried to take blood. No big deal. I hear some people struggle with that. I did not. Kidding. It was very hard. Austin helped me. The needle actually broke on the first one. Tough skin.
My name is Diego. I'm a filmmaker. A lot of what I do with Beneath the Waves on these trips is I'm shooting underwater. So while the shark is being tagged and it's in the water, I'm actually in the water with the shark with my camera, like right there, you know, foot away from the shark. And it's kind of amazing because when you're in the water, it's very kind of like peaceful and relaxing. You just see the animal there and seeing the eyes, the skin, the texture, the colors. And you know, we're here in the Caribbean, the water is just unbelievable. It's just turquoise blue, crystal clear. That perspective of seeing the shark and then the release is probably my favorite because, you know, after the 3 or 5 minutes of tagging the shark and doing all this research on it, being able to release it into the wild and seeing the shark actually, you know, go from being tagged to going back into the wild and back to its environment and, you know, seeing them healthy and swimming is always really exciting and great to see.
I got to swim away with him as we let him go, and he was a beautiful big nurse shark. Beautiful experience.
We had a new filmmaker, photographer Wilson Haynes, come in, and he's younger than us, so he's like his first trip. He's fresh, and it's always great to have, you know, new talent coming in and being able to share that experience. We've been doing this for so long, but to see someone else's perspective as well and that excitement as well for the first time is just, it's great. I mean, I love seeing that.
It was hectic at first because I'd never done pictures of shark tagging or anything like that before, so I definitely had to figure it out on the spot. It's really cool to see the professionalism that the Beneath the Waves team goes through to tag the sharks and to make sure those sharks are constantly okay and not being harmed in any way. And the amount of research we're able to gather in 5 minutes of tagging a shark is incredible. It's really cool to witness that from the boat and from being in the water when I'm trying to get those like split shots. Our job as photographers, creatives, and people who are researching this is to show the world they're not a dangerous animal. They're an animal that should be cherished and loved and taken care of because they do so much for us that we don't even realize. And it was really exciting to be around that energy and be with like-minded people who felt the same way I did about conservation and about photography and content creation.
It's one of the most important things I think our generation has to do is to really help conserve the ocean and push these stories forward, because I think that the research and the science is amazing. It's you know, fundamental to all of this, but really the thing that gaps it together to actually having impact, I believe, is having really compelling media that you can show not only to governments but to people and to inspire them. Because first you got to inspire people to fall in love with the ocean. And then you're gonna get them to be like, okay, well, actually we need to conserve this and start educating them to what's actually happening. And I think that's how you get people there. You first have to inspire them and kind of show them the beauty of it. And that's what I try to do with my work.
Amazing, living my dream life. Getting to tag sharks and let them go in the Turks and Caicos Islands.
Science.
More science research for the benefit of these sharks and Mother Nature.
It's really important data. It really is. Yes. You know, it's the first time this has ever really been done here to this degree. So we're going to hopefully start this in Turks and Caicos and then work in other places in the Caribbean too.
Yes.
I'm game if you're game.
So. I'm game. All about protecting our sharks.
But today we've come straight south of Provo again. We're back down by French Key. We've just come round past the wreck. Near Half Mile Reef, and we're picking up the second rough. It's a beautiful day on the ocean.
So on day four, we went to French Cay, and we were really looking for tiger sharks, and we had no luck up to then.
Out here on the banks, day's kind of halfway through, came back over to our rubs from earlier today, late morning, early afternoon, and saw the huge, unmistakable shape of the tiger shark. Probably 12-footer, massive, beautiful, super clean, major, major apex predator, and pulled up the rub that it was sitting on, essentially.
Oh my god.
Massive one, too.
This is mad.
Get the ball in the rub up. Never a dull moment here, and just goes to show you that seagrass and sandy banks are the best for tiger sharks.
Yeah, we just were able to spot these tiger sharks free swimming. We saw like four of them, and it was just amazing. Every time you see a tiger, it's always the most exciting moment of the shark tagging trip.
Right here!
What's happening?
We just saw a shark free swimming.
Is that a tiger or a reef?
Is that a tiger, it looks like.
Oh my.
Big, whatever it is.
Can we get it? Big shark?
Give me a big hug. Big bait, Jamie.
The way that we were able to actually pull up the drone and spot, you know, a little speck, and it's like, that's a shark, and bring it down and use like our, you know, photography technology to actually help the science and actually help track the animals was actually pretty amazing.
There's the shark.
We got the shark.
We got the shark.
Awesome. We got the shark on the drone.
So we'd be like, tell the captain, okay, the shark is where the drone's at, so we like pull up, and then we had that experience, and then after that, we were pulling up the brubs, and every single brub we pulled up, a tiger shark came up.
Yeah, pull the GoPro off real quick.
Yeah, you know, just seeing the abundance of that those animals was really special. Unfortunately, we didn't get to tag one, but even just seeing them from the top of the boat is incredible. And at one point, Austin and Philip jumped in, kind of caught us by surprise. Austin grabbed one of the camera housings and, you know, got a really great photo. definitely a little jealous that he got that interaction. I wish I would have jumped in as well, but those moments happen and it's, you know, a second. And if you're not on it, then that shark is gone.
And then when it turned, it booked it to the back of the boat. It was kind of sketchy because it was surfing the waves. Oh my God. It was, I didn't see it, and all of a sudden it was right in there. Wow, they're here, man.
Fortune favors the bold or the stupid. Right? That was sick.
I mean, it's clearly very seasonal here. I think they're here to eat the small whales, honestly.
We know where to find the tigers now. So now it's just continuing to layer on. Just science is a very, you know, derivative process. We're gonna come back down with our cameras. We're gonna come back down with our deep sea rigs and hopefully some electronic tags as well on the next trip, hopefully in the next few months. And we also really wanna start looking at the whales. Like, how are the whales responding and interacting with some of these other species? Are the tiger sharks here in Turks and Caicos here to prey or eat some of the smaller calving humpback whales? To be continued, but I think that there's just so many cool stories here in Turks and Caicos, and only time will tell. I felt
inside. We've got whales! Woo! Woo!